DevNet, that's now over 500,000 members, which has to have made your job very different. Talk about how you've built a community and then gotten that to sort of be a way that developers can help each other learn their craft together.
Yeah. So what was interesting is if we go back to when we started it, which was 5 years ago, it just involves evangelizing the idea, right? So again, being a startup, the first thing was to try to get support for the idea of, you know, your company wants, Cisco wants to have a software strategy, and there's many good reasons why you would do that. You want to move to a software model, the industry is going there, there's recurring revenue business models. But the real reason you want to go to software is to participate with the ecosystem. And to participate with the ecosystem, you need a developer program and a developer community. So I was just evangelizing for that, and I had to basically give 200 pitches across the company to finally get it up to the CEO, who then was like, you're right, we need to do this. But then after that, you get approval, but you just got approval. You don't have anything yet. So then the idea was to very quickly work with the community and build a website, a developer site for people to go, developer.cisco.com. Hold a developer conference at our main show. And that was like the first thing where our audience came and we said, are they ready for software? Will they actually come? Well, let's just pretend we have a developer program and let's hold a developer conference. And they came. So we got really early feedback because people attended, they found it valuable, and then we just tried more and more things together with them. So the key was like really evolving it, doing it with the community, getting feedback from them. Is this useful or is it not? If it's not useful to you, I'm not going to do it anymore. If it is useful to you, tell me why and how can I make it even more useful? And that's how we really built the program. And we actually did it with external people first and then brought it more and more into our own business as well. And we actually started out by partnering with the sales team because the sales team has systems engineers and sales engineers around the world who work with customers, and we had to train them to also be developer advocates so that they could have the reach, because we needed a scalable model because I don't have enough people on my team to get that coverage. So it's really about kind of figuring out creative ways to scale out and do things efficiently, but really growing your community to satisfy their needs first.